Welcome to e-Padasala PG program of students of computer science. Today we will be looking at instruction set for embedded systems. In this 8051 for 8051 microcontroller, the instruction sets will be referred in this class. So, the objective of this particular class is we need to discuss about the different addressing formats, and we will be looking at the instruction set of 8051, and will be some of the data transfer, arithmetic and logical operations can be done through certain instruction set that will be covered in this particular lecture. So, before proceeding towards the instruction set, we should know why we need to know about the instruction set of 8051. So, the first thing is when I am looking at a controller, we need to know how to speak to that particular process, so that it process the instructions. So, for that particular operation, we have to write a code. In that code, the code should be understandable by our 8051 controller. So, for that particular reason, an instruction set is developed for 8051. So, when we wanted to write a program, we need to look at that particular instruction set. Based on that only we have to write your assembly codes. So, basically the instruction set holds assembly instructions. So, rather I can call it as a mnemonics, and we will be writing all our process, all our program using only these instructions. This is like if I wanted to speak or write in English, I need to learn about what are all the characters which are available in English, then only I can write I can write anything in English. So, we need to know how to make a word, how to make a sentence, what are all the grammars. So, many things comes into picture when you are writing something in English, you wanted to communicate in English. The same way here also, when I am looking at the instruction set, the 8051 is will understand the instruction set which will be developed for that particular purpose. It cannot understand some other thing. So, we need to know about what is the instructions which has been written in the instruction set, and what is the rule with which it has to be written. That means, what is the grammar behind it, so that you have to follow that particular one, then only the system also will understand what we are trying to communicate to it. So, now we will look at if I am looking at the instruction set of 8051. First, we will be looking at the addressing modes. So, when I am looking at the addressing modes, we have register addressing, direct addressing, then immediate addressing, indirect addressing and indexed addressing. So, what is meant by addressing is, if I wanted to write an instruction in it, if I am using both source and resultant operands which is stored in registers, then I will call that particular instruction access only registers. So, I will call that instruction is coming under register addressing. So, direct addressing is if I am providing the address directly, then it is direct addressing. So, this is the way what is the way I will be representing my source or destination operands with the different addresses where it has been stored, which discriminates the instruction sets. So, now when I am looking at the register addressing. So, in this an example is move A, R5. As we know in the last class itself, in the 8051 architecture itself, we have gone through A is your accumulator and R0 to R7 is your general purpose registers. So, now if I am saying that a move instruction where move A, R5. Now, R5 is the register which is holding the data which will be moved towards your A. That is what we are trying to say. So, move A, R5 in the sense data stored in register 5 is moved to accumulator. So, it has been defined the move destination, source. Now, if the source and destination both the data are stored in only registers, then I will call this instructions coming under register addressing. So, now move A, R5, move R0, R1. So, here R1 data stored in R1 is moved to R0. So, all we know that the left first one which will be destination and the next one the right one will be your source. So, now we know that if both destination and source are hold available in only registers, then this addressing is called as register addressing. If I am looking at direct addressing, in this as I told you, the source and destination is stored in 8, either a source or the destination is stored in 8 bit address. So, the 8 bit address is nothing but which is telling you about pointing towards a space in the memory which is on the chip. So, now if I am looking at move R0 comma 20H. So, 20H is the address which is available in the memory, there the data is there, that data is moved towards R0. So, one of the operand which is stored in the memory and its address is given directly. So, this is called direct addressing. So, 8 bit address is specified in the instruction and either one source or destination is in address, that is what they are trying to say. Either move R0 comma 20 H is from 20 memory space it goes to R0, here move 20 H to R1. So, now R1 is the place where the data is available, now you move the data to 20 H address, that is what they are trying to say. So, the direct addressing is telling about the data is stored in a particular memory and the address is given directly on the instruction itself. So, this has been discriminated as direct addressing format. Next is immediate addressing. So, when I am looking at immediate address, it shows that the data itself is directly given in the instruction itself. So, move a comma hash 06H. So, what it says is 06 is the data which has been given directly in the instruction itself, immediately in the instruction itself. So, this 06 is the data immediately, if I am putting a hash which says that followed by whatever be the thing which is coming over here is nothing but your data, which will be now move a comma hash 06 is 06 is the data moved towards A, that is what they are trying to say. So, move R0 comma hash 0F CH. So, now this 0F we will be having FC is the data, FC is the hexadecimal number. So, only it has been ended with H and 0 is proceeded. Why? Because this it has to be said that FC should not be taken it as a ASCII character. So, because of that we have to say that it is a number and it is ended with H says that it is hexadecimal number. So, hash FC, this is a hexadecimal number which will be moved towards R0. So, hash tells you immediate addressing and FC tells you about the hexadecimal number, H tells you that this is hexadecimal number. So, the data directly moved to the register which has been happened with your immediate addressing. So, the data is immediately available in the instruction itself which tells you about immediate addressing. So, indirect addressing. So, next is your indirect addressing. In this actually the when you are looking at addressing thing, now I will say that at R0 is the source and A is the destination. So, at R0, at what it says is R0 is the register which holds the address and go and take the data from there and you put it in A. So, at tells you that the R0 is holding an address, not the data. Go to that particular address and fetch it, give it to A. Here, A is having the data, move at R1 comma A means A is holding the data which will be moved towards the address which is available in your R1. So, the at tells you that followed by whatever be the thing which is given as a register holding only address. So, this tells you indirectly. So, R0 is holding an address, you have to go over there, read the data and move it. So, now this is nothing but indirect. We have given the address indirectly in the register is called it as indirect addressing. So, in this mode of addressing, the instruction performs an operation on the data whose address is contained in registers either R0 or R1. That is what they are trying to say. So, 85th and assembly language symbol at before R0 and R1 denotes indirect addressing. So, the directly it was not given, it the address is indirectly given, that is what it is trying to say. Next is indexed addressing. So, what it says about indexed addressing is when I am looking at tells you that it is that it is not having a data, it is having only address. Now, A plus DPTR. So, now whatever the data which is available with your DPTR is added with A, content of A is added with DPTR. Now, that will be the address where you have to go and fetch it and put it over there. So, and the next one is when I am looking at DPTR, it tells you that it is a data pointer. Data pointer in the sense always the data which is available in outside is referred through this DPTR. So, 16 bit address is available in DPTR. This gets incremented by A, what will be the data which is available with your A. Now, I am getting this added value is the address which points outside, and I have to read it and move it to my A. So, this move C, the C tells you that it is the data is indexed addressing. That means, address is not directly given in the register, it has to be added, it has been indexed. Then you have to read it and put it over A, that too because of DPTR it is going outside. So, so only it has been given with move C, which is move code. It tries to convey move code from A plus DPTR is the address to your A, as well as move A plus PC. PC is getting incremented with A, what will be the value which is available with your A, and this is the address combined together. Now, I have to go and find out what is available over there, which should be moved to A. So, this is also indexed addressing. So, jump at A DPTR in the sense DPTR plus whatever the content of your A is added, where you need to jump. So, in this mode the 16 bit address in the base register is added to a positive offset to and from an to form an effective address. An effective address is found after adding the data. So, this is so only it has been called it as indexed addressing. Now, when I am looking at addressing modes in a program, I will have something like your Rn, I mean what is the way I will be representing has been illustrated over here. Rn means it tells you that R0 to R7. So, direct in the sense the data location to the address. So, at Ri means it tells you that the data is available in the internal read only, I mean random access memory location. Hash data tells you that it is data directly included in the instruction. Hash data 16, which tells you that 16 bit data is included in the instruction. So, address 16. So, 16 bit address destination address is given by your it has been given over there. So, these are the representations we will be using it in addressing modes in your assembly codes. So, when you are looking at anyway first we have gone through the addressing modes all the instruction which comes under any one of this kind of address modes. So, what is the way I will be addressing the data that discriminates the different category of your addressing modes within your instruction set. So, now when I am looking at instruction types I am telling that I am categorizing data transfer instructions, arithmetic instructions, logical instructions, boolean instructions and branching instructions. So, in this lecture we will cover one or two branches which will be in a broadly what are all the things which is available under this kind of instruction types. So, first we will go towards data transfer instructions. So, as we have gone through all your examples with your addressing modes where we will be using move. So, this is nothing but MOV is called used for moving data here and there. So, data transfer instruction has been used with the use of move, either move or move C or move X. So, the move destination comma source, this instruction allows data to be transferred between any two internal RAM or SFR locations without going through the accumulator. So, now the accumulator will not come into picture because we are not processing it through your ALU. Only when you wanted to process through ALU, any one of the operand is available in your accumulator. And when I am looking at a MOO operation where nothing is need to be processed. So, we will directly move from one location to other location. So, this is a table which shows you what is the kind of things we will be having it with your, I mean, complete way of writing your MOO instruction, that means your data transfer instruction has been shown over here. So, MOO A comma SRC. So, now I can have what will be the source which is available over there, which will be moved to our A. This is the operation we have done. So, I can when you are looking at the execution time is only 1 microsecond, that means already we have discussed 12 clock cycle is given for one machine cycle, was one machine instruction. So, it takes one cycle, one machine instruction to process this particular instruction. So, that way it has been discussed. So, what is the addressing modes and how many machine cycles it takes to process this particular instruction has been also given over there. Anyway, we will see what is the format with which it can be written. So, MOO destination comma A. So, now what will be the A, what will be the information available in A is moved to your destination. So, MOO destination comma source, it may be either a register or what will be the, I mean address or a register or what will be the thing. So, what source is moved towards destination, it can be a registers or it can be addresses or it can be data. So, anything is possible. So, because of that only it has been indicated direct addressing indexed as a register and immediate addressing, anything is possible over here. So, MOO DPTR hash data 16. So, now when I am looking at 16 bit data when I wanted to move, I have to have a 16 bit register. We have DPTR has 16 bit DPL and DPH together, I will have a 16 bit register. So, because of that I will be using this particular MOO DPTR comma has hash 16 bit data. So, that is the way, what is the data I am having it, that will be moved towards your DPTR. So, this can be used for only immediate addressing, because we have a hash over there, it is immediate addressing. When you are looking at push and pop is for stack operation. Push is for putting a data inside your, I mean stack top of your stack. Pop is for removing a data from your stack top. So, we will be push some source address, some address. So, stack top, whatever be the data which is available in your thing will be in your source will be moved towards your stack top. Pop is nothing but we will be taking the data from the stack top, putting at the destination. Okay. So, exchange is nothing but you will be exchanging the data between A and what will be the data. So, you will be exchanging the data between accumulator and the byte, XCHD, which is nothing but swapping the nibbles. That means, in your A we have 8 bit data, the lower 4 bit is LSB nibble and upper 4 bit is your MSB nibble. Now, I will be swapping the data of first 4 bits with the last 4 bits. That means, lower LSB nibble and the MSB nibble is getting swapped by in the accumulator using XCHDA. So, the exchange, just exchange in the sense it will do it that way, but XCHDA@RI is the two things. If I am not giving anything, the accumulator exchange only means the exchange, I mean accumulator data will be exchanged, but if I am putting it A@RI in the sense accumulator and @RI exchange the lower nibbles. If I am providing the source and destination, then I will be in a position to swap the lower nibbles, but if I am not giving exchange and I am not giving any of the variables in the sense, only the accumulator is taken as your operator, I mean the data is available in your accumulator is assumed and the swapped between two nibbles. So, when you are looking at your data transfer, where we have MOVX and MOVC is also there. So, what it says is MOVX is reading from external RAM. And maybe it may be requiring only 8 bit address. So, by the time MOVX A@RI in the sense, RI is the register, general purpose register, where I will be holding the data at one position, that memory address is available in your RI register, I should go over there, read it, and I have to put it in my accumulator. So this is actually this memory is placed externally. So because of that only they have given MOVX. So the only move in the sense I will say that it is internal RAM. If there is a move X is there, the X tells you that it is indirect addressing. You have to go outside, read it and come over there. So when you are looking at MOVX at RI comma AIS with right externally, you have to write the data. I mean whatever be the data which is available in AIS return to the address which is available in your RI and it has been placed outside. That is what it is trying to say. But remember that this RI when I am using it, it is only 8 bit address, but when I am looking at 16 bit address in the sense I cannot use registers normal R1 to R0 to R7 registers. I need to go for only 16 bit register, so that too your DPTR. So when I am looking at DPTR, at DPTR I mean MOVX A comma and DPTR in the sense the data is available in external memory and that memory is having the address which is available in your DPTR. Go to that particular address, read the data and move it to A. That is what they are trying to say. So, here 16 again MOVX at DPTR comma A, A whatever be the data I am holding it, I will be transferring towards my DPTR. That is what we are trying to do. So, remember that when I am looking at the previously when I am looking at the movement of data from register to register or direct data to register and all those things which takes only a single cycle, machine cycle. But when I am looking at this MOVX, when I am looking at the minimum at the most minimum two cycles is needed, machine cycles is needed, because I have to read the data, I mean I have to read the address, then I have to go outside, search over there, find out the data, then come and move it to either A or whatever be the destination. So, I need to go out and search the data, that takes more time when I am comparing with moving the data within the internal registers. So, because of that this particular data transfer MOVX or MOVC takes 2 clock cycles to finish off this particular work. So, when I am looking at MOVC, I am using 2 different instructions, one is MOVX and another one is MOVC. So, what is the difference between these 2 things is the similarity is both the MOVC and MOVX instruction tells you that your data is or either your data or program whatever be the thing which is available in your external memory, you need to access your data from external memory, that is what they are trying to say MOVC or MOVX. But when I am looking in depth, the MOVC tells that I am reading outside the code, C tells you the code. But when I am looking at MOVX, it tells you that the X tells you that you will be reading a data from outside. So, indirect addressing, it communicates indirect addressing, but either I am reading a program or a data that has been discriminated with your MOVC and MOVX. So, second thing over here is at A plus DPTR. So, whatever be the data which is available is the address at A plus the DPTR. The DPTR holds the address which will be added with the A content. Now, this will be the overall address, go to outside, search for it and find out what is the program which is a code which is a instruction which is available over there, read it, put it in your A. That is what they are trying to say. So, it takes minimum of 2 cycles. So, the same way MOVC A comma at A plus PC. So, here also I will be reading the program memory at A plus PC and I will be placing it towards my A. That is what trying to say. So, when I am looking at data transfer, it looks very simple, but it takes the source and destination if it is available in the main memory in the on chip, then it will not take time at all. But if I am putting something which is available outside, then it takes some time. Sometimes in the code, when you are writing an assembly instruction set, I may write the immediate addressing also. By the time I no need to search anywhere, I will be having a data in the instruction itself, I will be moving immediately. So, by the time it takes very less time to execute that particular instructions. So, when I am actually the example of the data transfer instructions, I have given some of the instructions which helps us to go through how the data transfer has been done through this MOO as a mnemonics. So, MOO destination, SRC, source to destination, assuming the location, maybe I will have an allocation 30H is equal to 15. That means, if I am having something like a data 30H, now if I am using it MOO or not, hash 30H. So, what it says is 30 is the data which is a assembly, hexadecimal data which is moved to R naught. Now, MOO A comma R naught. Now, I am considering R naught is having a 30H hexadecimal value which is nothing but an address. Go to that particular place which is internal memory, 30H is the address. I have to find out what is available over there, that gets moved to A. For example, if your 30H is having a data of 59H, now 59H is moved to my A. Now, move R 1 comma A. Now, whatever the data which is available in A is nothing but 59H, which is getting moved towards register 1 R 1. So, now if I am having move C A comma at A plus DPTR. So, whatever be the content of my A, which is nothing but 59H, which is getting added to what is available with your DPTR. Maybe it tells you this pointer, data pointer, that means an address from outside. So, this is getting added. Now, I have to fetch the data at this particular address, remember that, which is available outside, and I will be moving towards my accumulator. Maybe this is, and MOVC is telling that it is an instruction which is stored in that particular place. When I am looking at MOVX, where A comma and DPTR, what it says is DPTR holding the 16 bit address, go over there, read it, and go outside with that particular address, find out what is available over there, move that particular data towards your accumulator. This is what we will be trying to do when you are looking at your MOVX, and this X tells you that I will be reading the data from outside. So, when I am looking at data transfer instructions, I have something like all your data transfer instructions, what it does is I am reading data or instruction from either memory, I will be reading it the memory which is inside the 8051 or outside the 8051, that means external memory. And I will be providing the data in the instruction itself, or I will hold the data in my registers. Now, I will be moving this data from one place to next place for processing. This is what we will be doing it with your data transfer instructions. So, in this session actually we have gone through some of the instructions, we have gone through what are the addressing modes, and we have gone through the data transfer instructions, and all the data transfer instruction is done through only MOO, either MOO or MOVC or MOVX, and all these things is discriminated with where is your source and destination. Based on that, the different addressing format is also given. So, based on the addressing format, it takes lesser time or more time. If the data is available in the instruction itself, then it takes less time. If I am reading it from outside memory, then it takes more time. If it is inside memory, it takes one clock cycle minimum, minimum time it takes. So, when you are looking at these instructions, we should understand how the time is consumed, either through only processing, but remember that all your data transfer is not doing any processing, just it reads the data from one location and it moves towards the next location. So, for that itself, we have so many formats, so many different locations, so that the addressing is also different, and we have given what is the way, rather I can say the grammar to write it. So, the first one is this is actually destination and this is actually a source. So, now I have to move the source to destination. This is a way, this is the grammar with which it has to be written. So, in this session we have discussed a different addressing format, and we have discussed instruction, some of the instructions in the instruction set of 8051, and we have listed the data transfer instructions with some examples. And these things has been referred from Atmel 8051 manual and 8051 microcontroller and embedded system by Masthi book. So, these two are the reference you can go for further studies. Thank you.